Hello students of class 9. So today I am going to start the new chapter, that is chapter number 7, triangles. So what we mean by triangle, already we have studied triangle, what are triangle. So first of all, I am just giving you the basic terms what we are using in case of triangle. So triangle mein kya kya hota hai, pehle hum log wo humein dekh lete hai. So triangle, T-R-I-A-N-G-L-E-S, tri means what? Tri means three, that means we have in triangle we have three sides, three angles and three vertices. Vertices is the plural form of vertex. Okay, so see, this is a triangle. Here sides are represented with two alphabets. Okay, so I am just giving you the basic ideas and how to write angles, how to write sides. So see, the side AB is denoted by two alphabets, A and B. Similarly, side BC is denoted as AC. Okay, we have to use two alphabets for representing the sides. Similarly, CA will be this side. Okay, so these are the three sides. Next, come to the angle part. So what are angles? See, angle A, angle B, angle C. So already we have studied angle in our last chapter. So you know this. So how to represent angle like this, you have to represent. Next are the vertices. What are the vertices? A, B, C are the vertices. No need to write any symbol before A, B and C. Okay, vertex or vertices we have to represent using only one alphabet. Okay, so A, B, C are the three vertices of triangle ABC. Triangle ABC is denoted like this. This is the symbol of triangle and you have to write the alphabet which complete the triangle. So A, B, C completes the triangle. So you have to use three alphabets for denoting a triangle. Okay, so this is about the basic terms which we are using to denote the sides or the parts of the triangle. Okay, so next will be area. So area of triangle, you have already know, half into base into height is the formula. So sometimes we need to use the formula for finding area also. Okay, so next, which terms or which topic which we are going to study in this chapter, the important part, the important topic, that is congruency. What is congruence? Congruence, the spelling is C-O-N-G-R-U-E-N-C-E, congruence. The meaning of congruence means equal, they are same, they are similar, they are exactly looking, their looks is same. So the triangles are, if we say the triangles are congruent, then that means the triangles are totally equal, all the parts are equal. Okay, so there are some criteria which we have to study in this topic, under this topic. So by using that criteria we can prove that the triangles are congruent, or you can say the triangles are equal. Okay, so the first topic we will here we will we are going to study under the congruency of triangle is some criterias. And the first criteria is SAS congruence rule. Okay, so first of all we will start with SAS congruence rule. So the first rule, this is also called axiom, is two triangles are congruent if two sides and the included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and the indicated angle of the other triangle. So this rule is called SAS congruence rule. And one thing you have to remember, the symbol used to show congruent is this one. You have to write equal to, and above equal to you have to put the equivalent symbol. Okay, so this symbol is used for used to denote congruency, or you can say congruent if two triangles are congruent. Okay, so here in this particular rule it is given that if in two triangles the sides are equal, two sides are equal, okay, because SS means what? Sides. If two sides are equal and the sides which includes, the sides which include one angle, that is this one, see, these two sides include this angle. Similarly, if I take these two sides, this one AB and this one AC, AB and AC includes angle A. Okay, so here AB and BC includes which angle? Angle B. Okay, so this part, if the triangle follow this this equal criteria, then we can say that the triangles are congruent. So here what I have taken, see, the two triangles are there. So in triangle ABC and in triangle PQR, what are same? Here the side AB is equal to PQ. Okay? So the side AB, that means the length of the side AB is equal to the length of the side of PQ. So this is about side. Sides are equal. Next, see, which angle is equal? Angle B is equal to angle Q. This angle is equal. Okay, this is about angle. Next, BC is equal to QR. So BC is equal to QR. This is also about what? Side. So see what is happening here? Side, angle, side. That means side S, A, angle, side again S. So this is what? SAS rule. So SAS rule, by we can say the two triangles are congruent. Okay, we have to write like this: triangle ABC is congruent to, the meaning of this is congruent to triangle PQR. By which criteria? We can say by SAS criteria or by SAS congruence rule. Okay, so what will happen if the angle is not present here and it is present in here? That means angle C is equal to angle R. Then we cannot say that this is SAS rule, because the angle is not included in the equal side. Angle should be included in the equal side. Like here, angle B is included in the equal side, which the sides are equal. Okay, AB is equal to PQ and BC is equal to QR. So it should follow this rule. Angle should be included between the sides. Okay, so this is about SAS congruence rule. So the second rule or the second criteria for congruency of two triangles is ASA. Here what will happen, see, the side is included between two equal angles. Okay, the side is included between the angles. So two triangles are congruent, means two triangles are same, they are equal in all aspects, if two angles, that means two angles and the included sides. So this angle included this side, okay, this side AB of one triangle are equal to the two angles and the included side of the other triangle. So you have to see the other triangle. In the other triangle, this angle is equal to angle B, angle B is equal to angle Q, and the included side AB and PQ respectively are equal. So this criteria is called ASA congruence rule. That means by this rule we can say both the triangles are congruent. So how to write in order? So this is the order. First I have written angles are equal. Second I have written side. Then again I have written angle, because what I have to write? I have to equate like this. I have to write like ASA. Okay, I have to write like this because ASA is our rule. Okay, so this is about angle, side, angle rule. Okay, so by this ASA rule we can say both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so the first rule we have studied is SAS, and the second one is ASA rule. So one thing you have, one thing it can lay strike in your mind, that if ASA rule exists, so we can say that A, or we can say that SAA rule also exists. But no, this rule does not exist. Similarly, if you say that SAA exists, so you can also, you one confusion may be there in your mind, that SAS rule is also there. But no, SAS rule is not there. Similarly, if you say ASS rule, ASS rule is also not there. Okay, so our first rule was SAS, second rule is ASA. The third rule which we are going to study is angle, angle, side. That means one angle is equal to the other angle of the other triangle, and similarly second angle should be equal to the second angle of the other triangle, and third will be what? Side of one triangle will be equal to the side of the other triangle. Okay, here angle, angle should be angle, angle is there also equal. But see, side is not included. Like here, in this case, side is included between the two angle. Here, it is not compulsory. Okay, it is not compulsory. Side may be any side. Suppose these two angles are equal to the respective angles of the other triangle, and the third side may be BC or it may be AC. Okay, it is not compulsory that it should be included between the two angles. Okay, so our first one is SAS, second is ASA, and third is AAS rule. So for doing the first exercise, you have to remember these three congruence rule. Okay, SAS, ASA congruence rule, and AAS congruence rule. So by using these three rules, we can prove that the triangles are congruent. Okay, so after that, what will happen if the triangles are congruent? What will happen then? Then the corresponding parts of the triangle, that means here in this particular criteria or before that, the rule which we have studied, that is SAS rule, in that case, or you can say in that case, we have equated only three parts of the triangle, that is we are mentioning only three parts. But see, what are the different parts of a triangle? You know, there are three sides and three angles of a triangle. That means there are total six elements of a triangle. Here also six elements are there of a triangle. But here we are mentioning only three part, only three element. Okay, we are naming only three element. But what will happen to the remaining three element? So what will happen? See, if the triangles are congruent, then the remaining three elements will also be equal. Okay, so this is called CPCT. So the next part is CPCT, which I am going to write here. CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. That means the remaining parts which are left behind, that are also equal. But the triangle should be equal, then only we can say the corresponding parts are equal. Okay. So the next criteria, I already told you, AAS congruence rule, that is angle side congruence rule. So till now we have studied three criteria of congruency. The triangle will be congruent by using SAS rule, by using ASA rule, and the third one is angle side rule. Okay, so the remaining two criteria which I am going to discuss in the next lecture, that will be RHS and SSS. SSS means side. Okay, and the meaning of RHS is right hypotenuse side. Okay, right hypotenuse side. So these two criteria I am going to discuss in the next lecture. Okay, so using these three criteria, which we can simplify, we can prove the questions of exercise first. Okay, so next is CPCT. CPCT is, the full form is corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So what will happen? I already told you what will happen to the corresponding parts, the remaining parts. So if the triangles are congruent, then the remaining parts will be equal. Okay, this CPCT suggests that. So where we have to use, if in question they are asking about the congruency, so first of all you have to prove the congruency, that triangles are congruent. So by using these three rules, you can easily prove the congruency part. Then after that, if they are asking that what will happen to the remaining parts of the triangle, so in that case we have to use CPCT. So directly we cannot use CPCT, because CPCT can be used only when the triangles will be congruent. Okay, so first of all we have to prove the triangles are congruent, then we will use CPCT, that by using CPCT the remaining parts are equal. So in remaining parts, it may be angle or it may be sides. Okay, so try to go through this video. Okay, this is the topic which I have discussed today is very, very important, and in class 10 also you have to study this topic. Okay, again you have to study this topic. So using this topic we can derive many formulas also. Okay, so try to go through this topic from your book. Okay, and try to do some example questions for practicing. Okay, in next lecture I am going to start the first exercise. Okay, thank you.